copy. Okay. And till now, the maximum marks scored was 20. Okay. And basically, whatever maximum of you did, 50% problem was correct. But the later 50%, the last portion, you did a little bit wrong. Okay. So today, before the continuation of the third module, that is the transformer, impedance transformer, first today we will solve the questions, okay, class test questions. Question number, questions will be solved. Okay, let others join, then from 3-6, your class will start. Okay, and then if we have time, then we will start studying the continuation of the transformer. Clear? And within 3 or 4 days, I think I will be able to give you the answer sheets. Okay, it will be given in Google Classroom. Okay, the checked answer sheets will be forwarded there. Clear? And regarding the HOD sir, but HOD sir told me that to give you another chance. Okay, so for that violation of rules, I am not deducting any marks for this class test. Okay. But please remember, from the second class test, follow the rules. Okay. I will give you another 10 minutes for uploading. Right. So try to follow the rules. Okay. Okay, after 2 minutes, your class will start. Let others join. Then we will. Okay, so it's almost 3:08. Good afternoon again. And is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So this one was your first class test question, as you can see. Okay, the first numerical all of you did right. That is, as per logic of Thevenin's theorem, any two terminals of a bilateral network can be replaced with a network that is an independent voltage source, and that source is called the Thevenin voltage or the open circuit voltage, right? In series with the equivalent resistance. That means your circuit will look like this is your voltage source, okay? And in series, this is your RTH, okay? And here you will put the load RL, okay? And this independent voltage source is called either Thevenin voltage source or open circuit, right? Both are equally correct. Now, next one is the which is the following nonlinear parameter. Now, why some of you are writing that inductance is nonlinear parameter, some of you chose the condenser parameter, and some of you chose the wear on resistor. First of all, resistor won't be selected at any cost here. Why? Because V equals to IR or Ohm's law. Okay. And if V is increasing,
Screen not visible.
Okay. Just a minute. Okay, is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
So here, first of all, the wear wound resistor, it doesn't have any chance because V equals to IR. So it forms Y equals to MX, straight line. Okay, so how it is nonlinear? It is obviously a linear parameter. Okay, now next one is the nonlinear inductance. Okay, now in case of inductance, what is the formula that we know? It is V equals to I into XL in case of AC. And if you choose the formula V equals to L di dt, then what is di dt? That di dt is the slope. Okay, but V and di dt, if di dt increases, V also increases. So L is also give you a linear parameter. Okay, so inductance will also not stand a chance here. Now, next one is the condenser. Now, can you tell me what is condenser? Any idea?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please tell.
It is used in the fan to store the capacity and to regulate its speed.
Exactly. So basically, the condenser is the form of capacitor. Okay. It is called the capacitor. Okay. That means the condenser is used to store the charge. Basically, its function is like a capacitor. Okay. So it is also a linear parameter, not nonlinear. But in case of transistor, it is of nonlinear parameter. If you see the current characteristics of the transistor in the first or second class, I had shown you the waveform that increases in case of transistor. Okay, it's like this. At several base current, several output currents are there. So it is basically nonlinear in nature. Okay, this lower region is called the cutoff region. This region is called the saturation region. Okay, just a minute. Hey, ball.
So, ekto pore kor ami class e achi. Class e. মোটামুটি আধ ঘন্টা পরে কর, ঠিক আছে? হ্যাঁ, আমাকে আধ ঘন্টা পরে কর, আধ ঘন্টা 40 মিনিট পরে কর, বেশ।
Okay, so this region is called the saturation region. This is called the cutoff region. Okay, and this region, the other regions, this one is called the active region. Okay, so basically the function of the transistor will show you that the parameters here are non-linear in nature. Okay, but in case of resistor, V equals to IR, Y equals to MX, correct? Similarly, in case of capacitor, in case of inductance. Is there any query regarding the second question? Is there any problem in second question? Or should I move to third? Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So till now there is no query. Okay, so third one, an ideal voltage source should have the zero source resistance. Okay, because if that resistance is less, then the total voltage can be generated. Otherwise, some internal loss will be there, and net value of the voltage you will receive when you measure, that will be less than the original. Okay, third one is the correct answer is C. Okay, now fourth one is the three resistors of 4, 6 and 8 ohm are connected in parallel. Now some of you has chosen this 4 ohm, some of you had chosen 6 ohm, but they are all wrong. Why? Because when this is your source, voltage source, okay, one resistor here, another resistor here, another resistor here. So they are in 4 ohm, 6 ohm and 8 ohm respectively. Okay, so what is the formula for power dissipation? Can you tell me?
I square R.
Why? See, all the parameters, what is the reference here? What is your reference value here? V is the same for all. Yes? Is it okay? V is the same for all the resistors. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So, yes, sir. Here, V is same for all the resistors. So, here, in case of parallel, instead of that I square R formula, here formula will be V square by R. Okay, clear? Fine. Now here look, this V square by R. So where R value is less, this total power dissipation value will be high, right? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Also, from the I square R, if you follow the rules that I square R, you will also calculate. Okay, see here, 4, 6, 8. So if you calculate the nodal analysis, here how much current will flow through the 4 ohm, how much current will flow through the 6 ohm, how much current will flow through the 8 ohm, you can easily calculate. And from there, follow that I square R, you will get the same answer. So here, in between this 4, 6 and 8, in between 4, 6 and 8, the V square R, if you rule is, if you apply, then less the voltage, more will be the power loss. So here, 4A is your correct answer. Is that okay? Now, fifth, a voltage source with resistance in series can be converted to a current source with its resistance in parallel. It is basically the rule of source conversion. Okay, how it is converted? Suppose you are drawing, you are having one system like this. okay, one voltage source and one resistor in parallel, in series. Okay, now this system can be converted like this. I source, okay, and one resistance in parallel, right? This can be drawn like this. Okay, now how will we check that whether we are drawing this correctly or not? Now look, if you see from this open end, then what is the voltage you had observed? What is the voltage you are observing? What voltage you are observing from that open side? Arjit Bandyopadhyay, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Arijit Bandyopadhyay, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then ask my question. What will be the answer if I see from this open side, then what will be the voltage I will get? Ankita Kumari, what will be the voltage I will see from the open side?
So please repeat the question again.
Here one voltage source is present, okay?
Yes, sir.
And in series one resistor R is there, okay? Now yes, if I look from this side, that arrow mark, okay?
Yes, sir.
What is the value of voltage we will get?
Sir, IR is equal to IR.
That means V.
Yes, sir.
Right. That means V is your ultimate answer. Okay. Similarly, if you convert that source, then this I, this source, I current source, has only one path, that is through the R. Okay, so if current is flowing like this, then this side will be positive, this side will be negative, and what will be the voltage drop? That will be V, I into R, right? So I into R equals to V. So similarly, if you look from this side, same voltage you will get, that value is V. So we can say that this conversion is right. Okay, and the current direction will be like this. Okay, now next question. Each branch of the star network has resistance of 5 ohm. The value of the resistance of each branch of the equivalent delta network is, see, if equivalent delta, star delta transformation is there, then from this star to delta conversion, always the resistance will increase 3 times. Okay, this is a similar network. Okay, that means symmetrical network. All the branches are consisted with the resistance value of 5 ohm. Okay, now if you convert that system into delta system, then each branch will have the 15 ohm resistance each. Okay, it will be 3 times. And if delta system is present in your question, okay, suppose the value is 12 ohm. Each side has the 12 ohm resistance. Now if you convert that into star system, then each side will have 4 ohm resistance. Okay, basically this star delta conversion is not in your syllabus, okay, but as it is given, So you have to remember this thing. If it is symmetrical network, then delta, the resistance value of each branch in delta will be 3 times of the star branch. Okay, and vice versa is also you have to remember. Now, next one is the independent variable in mesh analysis is your mesh current, because here mesh current is not depending, right? Now, next one, Thevenin theorem is not applicable to the network containing elements of unilaterals. Now, can you tell any unilateral element?
So diode.
Correct. That means PN junction diode. Diode is one type of unilateral element. Okay. So if unilateral element is present, then neither Thevenin theorem nor the Norton theorem nor the superposition theorem will be applicable. Right. Next, superposition theorem can be applied to all type of sources. That means current source, voltage source and power source. Any type of source if you have, you can apply superposition theorem very easily. Now KCL is applicable to the junction in a network. That means this junction is called what? It is called the node. Okay. Now next one is this numerical. Determine the current through 6 ohm through the using the mesh analysis. Okay, so maximum of you had solved it correctly. Okay, so this is the mesh analysis you have to form. That means one current will flow like this. This may be I1. Okay, and another current will be here. That value will be I2. Okay. Now some of you already did there some mistake during the calculation, okay, but some part marking also I gave, correct? So no need to solve this right now because 90% of you had solved this correctly. Next, find out the current flowing through 6 ohm resistance using the Thevenin theorem, okay? And also find out the internal resistance of the circuit. This one was also easy. Because using Thevenin theorem, if you are told to calculate the current flowing, then what you have to do? You have to omit this source, then find out the voltage here, that is VTH, okay? And then the RTH value you have to find out. So VTH value you had calculated was 9 volt, which was absolutely correct. And the RTH value, voltage source will be shorted, current source will be open circuited. So RTH value will be 4.5 ohm, right? Why? Because if voltage source is shorted, then this 5 ohm and this 5 ohm will be in parallel. So 5 parallel 5, it will give you 2.5 ohm. And this circuit will be, this part will be open circuited because current source is present. So here 2.5 and this 2 ohm are in series now. So RTH value is 4.5. Regarding the question number 1 and 2, is there any confusion? Then unmute yourself and speak.
No, sir.
Okay. Now, third one. Maximum of you did some mistake. Okay. Why? Because look here, what is given? The calculate the current flowing through the 5 ohm resistance. So that means you have to calculate the current flowing through the 5 ohm using superposition. Okay. So what are the cases? Okay, let me share another screen first because I have to solve this. Okay. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So, first numerical that was given, it is one source is there. Okay, let me check. 2 ampere, 10 volt, 10 ohm. Okay, 2 ampere, 10 volt. That means 10 volt. This is 2 ampere current. Okay, this is 2 ampere. This is 10 ohm. Okay, this is your 10 volt. And with this in parallel 5 ohm is present, and with that in parallel 1 ohm is present. Okay, so this is your 5 ohm, this is your 1 ohm. So in if you use the superposition rule, there are two circuits you have to draw. Okay, so first case you have to consider the 2 ampere source. Okay, so 2 ampere source will be taken into consideration, and what should we do about the 10 volt source? Tell me.
Short circuit.
Okay, so this section will be short circuited. Okay, then 5, then 1. Okay, so this is your 10, this is your 5, this is your 1, this is your 2 ampere. Okay, so now obviously you have to do the current divider rule, correct? Now look, you have to calculate the current flowing through the 5 ohm. So this 10 and 1, they are in parallel, so eliminate this 10 and 1. Okay, so check this. Can I draw like this? Okay, can I draw like this? 1, 5 ohm is here, and instead of 10 and 1, I am writing here the parallel value of 10 and 1. 10 by 11. Is it okay? Check.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is it okay to everyone? Because this value is nothing but the parallel calculation of 10 ohm is in parallel with 1 ohm. Okay. So basically, from here you are getting the equivalent value 10 into 1 divided by 10 plus 1. Okay, so from here you will get this value 10 by 11. Okay, clear? So now you can apply the current divider rule. Now you have to calculate the current through 5 ohm. So we will choose this 10 by 11. Is it okay? So first I 5 dash equals to what is the base current, that is 2 into 10 by 11 divided by 5 plus 10 by 11. Now quickly calculate and tell me what is the answer you are getting. Okay, calculate this one first and tell me what is the value of I5 dash.
Sir, 0.30.
0.30. Everyone please check, because I don't have calculator right now. Okay, you have. So everyone check. 0.3 ampere. Okay. Into 10 by 11, so here 11 into 5, that means 65, total 20 by 65. Okay, so that means whether it is correct or not, tell me.
Yes sir, correct.
Okay, so it's okay, so we have majority vote, fine. So now this is done. Next, what we have to do? We have to choose the 10 volt, right? And the current source will be what? Current source will
open,
be?
Open circuit.
Exactly. So current source will be open circuited. Okay. Next, this is your 10. This is your another 10. So here, what rule I need to apply for fast calculation? Tell me. Simple, nodal analysis.
Yes.
Okay. Here this is 1. Here this is 5. This is your 10. Okay. Here this is 10. Please speak the point where you don't understand. Okay. Now, in case of nodal analysis, see this node point I am writing as V. Correct? So, what will be the equation? That will be 10 minus V divided by 10. Okay, this is your input current, right? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next, what will be your output current? V by 5 plus V by 1. Is that okay? Clear?
Yes, sir.
So now calculate the value of V. What value you are getting? Tell me. Okay, that value will be somewhat V by 10 plus V by 5, V by 1, that means 13 V by 5 equals to 1. Okay. So that will be 13 V by 10. So that will V will be 10 by 13. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
10 by 13?
Yes, sir.
Volt. Okay. So, what is the value of I5? Quickly tell me. I5 double dash. Okay. What is the value? That will be 2 by 13, isn't it? Because V value is known to you. So V divided by 5, that means 2 by 13. Okay or not? Yes or no, please reply, because I don't know whether this calculation is okay,
sir,
or not.
2 by 13.
Yes, 2 by 13.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now 2 by 13 is your I5 double dash. And now what we have to do, we have to add or subtract. Which one? We have to add or subtract. Which one? These two current? Because in both cases, the current is going in same direction, that is downward, correct? So, yes, so we have to basically add, correct? So what is the value of 2 by 13? Check.
2
that value
0.15.
Okay, fine. 0.154 basically. Zero. This value is 0.154. Okay. Now, if you add those, you will get 0.454. Okay. Clear? Okay. Check this voltage is 10 volt or 20 volt. This voltage is 10 volt, 10 ohm. Okay. Good. So that's how you have to solve the numerical. So the value is 0.454. Is that okay? Is this okay to everyone? Then we will go to the next numerical.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So what is the next numerical that was given? Okay, let me check the numerical. Another one was given, that calculate the Norton resistance considering the 1 ohm as the load resistance. Okay, then tell me what will be that numerical, that if you look from the 1 ohm, okay, if you look from the 1 ohm, as if 1 ohm is your load resistance, then what will be your Thevenin or Norton equivalent resistance? Quickly tell me, because that one is very easy. Because in that case, that source will be open circuited. Okay. This one will be short circuited, right? This 5 ohm will be present, and this 1 ohm we need to omit. That means we have to open circuit. Okay. So this 5 and 10 are in parallel, right? So what is your Norton equivalent resistance or Thevenin equivalent resistance? Because the process is basically same. So whether you call it as Norton equivalent resistance or Thevenin equivalent resistance, both are basically same. Okay. RTH. So what is the value here? The value is 10 parallel 5. So that means 10 into 5, okay, divided by 10 plus 5, that means 15. So what is the value? Check.
3.33.
The value will be 3.33. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. 3.33. Why this pen is not working? 3.33 ohm. Now moving on to the next numerical. Okay. Okay, in next numerical, most of you did one thing wrong. Okay, what thing? That one arc was there, okay, and you are told to calculate the current flowing through that arc. Okay, so let me draw that equation for that circuit first. Okay, so this one was one current source, okay. One resistance is in parallel, that is your 15. Okay, that value is 15 ohm, and then in here 6 ohm is present. Okay. Next, here 6 volt is there. This side is positive. This side is negative. This value is also 6 volt. Okay. This is your 6 ohm. This is 5 ohm. Okay. And this one is how much? 2 ampere. Next, here another source is also present. I think one resistor is present, and then 8 volt. One resistor is here. Okay. Okay, what is the value of the resistor? Do you remember that?
Yes, sir, 3 ohm.
3 ohm. Oh,
its value is 3 ohm. Okay. This is your R. Okay. And some of you just neglected this voltage source. There is another voltage source. When you omit that R, you also had omitted that voltage source. Okay. So that was not right. You need not to erase that voltage source. Okay. You don't need to erase that voltage source immediately, because if you erase that voltage source, that will be, where is that drawing? Oh, okay, now it is here. Fine. Just a minute. Okay, now it is here. Okay, so when you omit that resistance, when you are removing this resistance, you cannot remove this voltage source immediately. Okay, so what you can do in case of this Norton theorem, in this case, this your circuit will be converted into this 2 ohm. Okay, this is not working here. Okay, I will show you this. I will send you the solution of this numerical in WhatsApp group. Okay, somewhere it is showing this an error. Okay, so all of you give your attendance in the chat box. I will send you that solution of this numerical later in WhatsApp group. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you everyone for attending the class. Quickly give your attendance in the chat box. Thank you. And if you have given, you may leave the meeting.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Sir.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.